Rescue crews have found a survivor in a Siberian coal mine where dozens of miners are presumed dead after a devastating methane explosion, a senior regional official said on Friday. Acting Emergency Minister Alexander Chuprian identified the survivor as rescuer Alexander Zakov Ryashin, who had been presumed dead. "I can consider it a miracle," Chuprian said. Zakov Ryashin was conscious when rescuers reached him and has been hospitalized with moderate carbon monoxide poisoning, according to emergency officials. Authorities on Thursday confirmed 14 fatalities, 11 miners and 3 rescuers who perished while searching for others trapped in a remote section of the mine. 6 more bodies were recovered on Friday morning, while 31 people remain missing. Authorities now put the presumed death toll to 51. Steve Leoff said finding other survivors at this point was highly unlikely. Rescuers were forced to halt their search for survivors following Thursday's methane gas explosion and fire because of a buildup of methane and carbon monoxide gas. A total 239 people were rescued from the mine, 63 of them so far have sought medical treatment, according to Kemerovo officials. The accident appears to be the deadliest at a Russian mine since 2010, when 2 methane explosions and a fire killed 91 people at the Raspudskaya mine in the same region. In 2016, 36 miners were killed in a series of methane explosions in a coal mine in Russia's far north. In the wake of that incident, authorities assessed conditions at the country's 58 coal mines and declared 20 of them potentially unsafe. Media reports say the Lysvyuznaya mine wasn't among them, however. In 2004, a methane explosion in the mine killed 13 people. Russia's top independent news site, Meduza, reported that this year authorities suspended operations in certain sections of the mine 9 times and fined the mine more than 4 million rubles, roughly $53,000, for safety violations. Law enforcement officials also said Friday that miners had complained about the high level of methane in the mine. Regional officials have declared 3 days of mourning while Russia's investigative committee has launched a criminal probe into potential safety violations.